Hello, everyone. Let's talk about the locking bars for the Valhalla Doors. First of all, a little review. Daniels Woodland is an amazing outfit of very creative people, and I had the honor to be asked to create a grand entrance for their facility, where they'll have Imagineers and all sorts of wonderful people coming in. Now, the main goal for this stage of the door is to not only make it look nice, but to be, for them, you know, for them working there to be able to lock their doors at night. For years, they had to screw in a 2x6 to keep the thing closed. Not anymore. I didn't want to lean too hard into the Viking Nordic kind of aesthetic, as much as I love it. I wanted to give room also for a little bit of steampunk. I don't know. I want you to be bewildered by the time period it was built. Maybe the door was built several hundred years ago, and then the locking mechanism was additions. You know, so many castles and historical creations were that way, where you would have generations of craftspeople adding and continuing to develop and inspire each other. Now, I built this model because I needed to feel the mechanism. I wanted to feel resistances where I would find them. When it comes to precision, I really mean it. The 64th is a mile with a lot of this work, even though it's 20 feet long. So when it comes to a piece of this scale, there's a lot of just raw material, just straight raw material. And it's always a significant challenge to break that up, to make everything look extremely detailed. You know, every square inch had tens of hours put into it. You know, that's why you break every corner and hot forge every corner and hot rivet everything together. You know, all of the strong ties had to be forged, because when you have something so big, you really need to still have that attention to detail. I want the work to be equally as wonderful and splendid the closer you get to it. You know, when you get close up to the work, you don't just see like, oh, they just kind of, you know, filled this in with just some kind of mediocre stuff. No, no. There needs to be details among details underneath details.
okay, everybody, now that the guides are pretty much buttoned up together, it's now time to cut out and, well, pretty much to take from this page and put down here so I can cut it all out. These guides that go on the door, the little buckets, they're not gonna be very small, but yeah, so all of these elements. So that's what I'm doing. I've been taking measurements from here and going over here. That's one of the reasons why I like to draft everything to scale, so that I'm able to just take measurements right from the plan sets and then put them down onto steel.
So, always, the most exciting part is to make it beautiful. You know, even though it's something very functional and utilitarian, it's always exciting to make it awe-inspiring, to make somebody feel something. That's the whole reason for art in general, is to evoke imagination and splendor and a sense of wonder about it all. This pair of locking bars is an immense undertaking. This is just the beginning of what I have envisioned for them. Oh, I just can't wait to show you more. Stay tuned for part 2, and thank you so much for watching.